Well, hello. This is Bowtie Dave on a very special day. This tree right here is the subject of this video, and if anybody's been following along on what we've been doing, you may know what's already happened. But I wanted to show just some of the process of taking down a massive, massive tree. And this tree was huge, enormous. It was a great shade tree, but on the other side of this tree, it has a lot of stress. It has a lot of stress in it, and the bark is damaged and leaking, and it's not gonna get better. The tree person, who is Luke Rieger over at Rieger Tree Service, and I'll put a link down in the description to his website, but he's the one that's done the work here and is taking this tree down. He's the one climbing up, and one of his helpers, Parker, helped from the ground, and then me and my neighbor here, we did a lot of moving brush and pulling ropes and a lot of other stuff, because you've probably already guessed, it's down. And I wanted to show you this tree right here. It's huge. Yep, I have chaps on and a bow tie, but this thing, it's actually about twice as broad this way than it is this way. It's an enormous, enormous tree. And we are very excited to have it down. It's been a year deciding to do this, and I didn't want to do it when we first moved into the house, because you just shouldn't make big decisions like that right away, I don't think. I mean, we could have made the decision, but I wanted to be sure. And after a year of growing in our garden, we're pretty certain that it was time, because we did not have a great year in the garden. And not only that, Mrs. Bowtie likes having a little bit more sun on the patio over here, which is just this area right back over here. In fact, you can see the white table is sitting on the patio, but if you've watched my garden tours, you've seen the patio before. And we will probably end up, I've talked about the trellis here, and of course one post is missing right, somewhere right in here there's a post that's missing, but it'll be put back up. It's just down temporarily. And the chain link fence here is down temporarily. It's actually rolled up over there. But we'll get everything put back together, and we'll probably end up getting the 4x4 post, 4x6 post put across the top of this trellis on each side. In fact, if you've seen Roots and Refuge, where in front of their new house, they put in a small temporary garden, and this is a very similar structure to what they built. So it was a lot of inspiration from Roots and Refuge when we built this. In fact, I don't know what their dimensions are. I can't remember off the top of my head, but it's pretty similar. And so we hung the cafe lights and everything off of there, and put the raised beds in, and a lot of shade. The beans did great. Tomatoes didn't do so great. We'll end up having to put shade cloth now for the Florida sun, but we'll work it out. We're gonna work out where everything goes. So anyway, I'm exhausted. We did a lot of work on this big tree. We actually left 15 feet, actually maybe closer to 16 or 17 feet of this tree. And I have a jasmine vine. If you've seen the end of the outer garden bed tours, you've seen the past few months, you've seen the jasmine that I've had in a pot over here. Well, I think it's gonna end up growing up this trunk. We're talking about either the jasmine or wisteria. And Jesse over at plot 37, there's been a few people that have shown some wisteria that just got me excited. So we'll have to see what we end up doing. My neighbor over here does have some jasmine, some huge jasmine bushes, and the bees love it. So we'll get something nice in here that gives us some flowers. But anyway, so this video, we've got a bunch of different parts of this video. Some is sped up video and some is actual speed. We actually put the tripod up on the roof so you could see the whole upper tree as they started taking it down. And we did, there's going to be a section here where you can see the tree coming down in fast speed. And then I came down and shot some of the dropping of the branches by hand, and then went back up there for the last, the last video is like an hour and a half, and I'm not going to play all that for you. I'm going to try to get some editing done on that so that it's a little more interesting, but we'll see what we can do with my software. And there we go. So very excited. It's a whole different place. It's already a whole different feel out here, and we'll have this summer to figure out if we made a mistake in anywhere and what we need to do to correct it. Because there are things, you know, we do things like this and we can figure out what to do. It just may be a change in plan. But Mrs. Bowtie and I have been talking about taking this tree down since we moved in here about 14-15 months ago. So it was gonna happen. But anyway, so here's the removal of the big tree, and in the next garden tour there's not gonna be a tree. So there'll just be this trunk, and I don't know when I'm going to get the jasmine planted, or if I can, or what I need to do to get it planted. We'll have to do a little figuring out there. So here we go. Hi, I'm Bowtie Dave. Throughout the rest of this video, we're going to be pretty much playing the theme song over and over. A little bit of the sound in the background. I actually yelled with the camera in my hand a few times as we were communicating. So I've turned the volume down for the most part. But just enjoy the music and the process. This is the part that fascinates me the most. Just watching this thing be disassembled. It's really quite amazing. Feel free to skip around. There is a very long segment of video near the end. The final scenes from the roof of the last piece is coming down. That starts somewhere around the 17 or 18 minute mark. From the tree, and look what I found. This little pepper plant right here is starting his new growth. From here up died. I could cut that back, but it's not the only one. Look over here. Peri-peri starting to grow. Little leaves. Another peri-peri growing leaves. That's so exciting.
About that garden. Nothing in it that can't be planted again.
is Editing Bowtie Dave coming at you from after the fact. And through this section of the video kind of just shows the dropping of the branches. And I had to turn off the camera and go help direct the branch. So there is a little bit of cutting here, just a smidge too early. And the tripod, well, I thought about putting it on the tripod, but the tripod is still up on the roof. So you will see the final few pieces coming down from that here in just a little bit.
Squirrel can't make up her mind while pirate watches.
So we have a mother squirrel with two babies, very confused about all the nests disappearing in this tree. She's right up in here somewhere. I don't know where she's gone.
Very intimidated by onlooking pirates.
I don't know if she's coming your way or not, Luke. Oh,
she,
oh, good. Oh, whoa, there she goes. Yes, she did. No. So this is editing Dave coming at you in the corner of the video. At this point, it's a very long segment, and if you don't want to watch the whole thing, feel free to skip to the end. I pretty much just set the camera on the roof, on the tripod, and just let it record. This is regular speed. There's nothing sped up like that small section at the beginning of this video. So if you just want to watch the little pieces come apart, that's kind of what this is, and just the final pieces. And that's Luke way up there on the tree right now. He spent most of the day. It took about 8 hours to get this tree down. It was a lot of work, and he did a great job. You see that it was very organized, very safe. Everything, he was double harnessed in the whole time, and the helper on the ground, he knew exactly how to lower the pieces just right, and they had everything just well in control. It was a very smooth operation, to say the least. They did great, and we were so pleased to have him here. It was a lot of work that there was no way I could have ever done, and we were very happy to have him do this for us. So enjoy the rest of the video. This is just kind of the way the rest of the video is going to go.
here, hold this with the arms.
Yeah.
scouts. Oh, yeah. And I had to teach them how to tie a square knot. It's like a rabbit, man. You make the hole, you come out the hole, you go around the pole, you go back out through the hole.
Stronger than me. I'm kind of scared to
peek
against him.
Yeah, he goes to work out for like 2-3 hours
every day. Oh, no. That was one time.
Yeah. Hey, and that's what it was last week.
Okay, it does happen every so often.
Are we doing one big cut here?
Yeah, I'm going to do a big cut.
Just drop it.
And then after that, I'm going to drop what's left.
Okay. Oh, okay, great.
Let me, look at him. He's so excited.
Hey, you know,
let me move your rope out of the way. Excited to see this. I think I've got your rope all piled up right, but your rope is tangled in your green safety line. The loop around.
Is this enough carriers to change my
weight?
pull. So he can pull it while I'm cutting it, so I don't pinch myself.
Ah.
I think gravity's got the edge here anyway. That's what you got to think of. Gravity, you ready?
Good job.
That was a good shot.
too far.
Right at the right here at the bee? Or how you want this?
Can we do it just below? Can you cut that? Just below the bee? Oh man.
I'll have to do it in three pieces.
Yeah, that was a good one.
exactly. About 3 inches too short.
This is editing Dave coming in the corner of the screen again, and you see me standing there in the background with the orange chaps on, and I'm not helping a lot because not too long before this I had just had the mother of all leg cramps and was still recovering, hobbling around a bit, but these guys were doing great. I just wanted to hop in here for just a second because this piece he's cutting off right now, when it fell, it shook the ground. Everybody felt it, but watch as it hits the ground and the camera, which is sitting on top of the house, 60 feet away, maybe 50 feet away, shakes. Even the camera on top of the house shook a little. That thing was so heavy. Wow.
Hey, Bill, let's loop it, go to the other side, okay? 3, 2, 1, go. Again, 3, 2, 1, go.
I'm not getting you stuck. Ready, 1, 2, 3,
go. Okay, hold on. Stop the time up here. Okay.
And my line's not stuck on up there, down, right?
Yeah, it's down.
So there it is. The tree is down. Took about 8 hours of work. Luke Rieger over at Rieger Tree Service, he's actually one of my neighbors. We're very blessed to have him here. Did a great job. He spent all day up in that tree. And you saw in the video, he spent a long time up there and did a lot of work. This is the biggest piece that came off here. Let me tell you something, when it fell, in fact, you should have been able to see that in the video. When it fell, it made a mighty thump, and it didn't bounce, nothing. It just went thump and shook the ground. But I'll walk over here and you can kind of see how big it is. It's big. In fact, when Luke was cutting this tree. It's so far across that his 30-inch bar couldn't reach all the way through. We had a little trouble getting this piece down. And we were talking about getting another piece down from here that was a little bigger. And I think he was kind of happy when we decided to stop where we did. But, oh my. Now we have a lot of firewood. And this stuff will have to sit for a year, and this will be firewood for next year. It's not going to burn well for this year. So as for what I'm doing, I will be putting it on the sunny side of my house and cover it over with black tarp or black plastic, and let it season, let it dry out before we do any splitting. We're not going to break our backs trying to split this wet wood. But so interestingly, we did see there is in the center of the tree, there is deadwood developing, and there's splitting happening. And you can tell that somewhere around somewhere between 12 and 16 years ago, there was something traumatic happened to the tree. And you can see in the rings there was a bad time. We'll have to go back and look at the weather records. I don't know if it was during winter or what, but something happened to this tree and really stressed it. We did have some squirrels. We had a mama squirrel with two babies that were up this tree, and I held at least one of them twice, or I held both of them. The mother is actually just about 20 feet over here climbing a post, but one of the babies went back up the tree, and another one I grabbed and took it back over into the blueberries, and he made his way back up the tree. Parker got one of them over in a old tree over here, and eventually we saw the mama come down with one of the babies. We knew one of the babies was still up in that single piece that was still up there. It's not why we left it up there, just where they went. And that baby eventually came down with a branch, unfortunately, but it was okay. And I had my thick gloves on, and I was able to hold it gently. And we knew what tree the mother had gone up with the other baby. So we put it on the tree, and it just scurried right up the tree. It was very cool, hoping that maybe he found his mother up there. There's a lot of squirrel activity in that big tree. It's another big tree just like this one was, but it is in a lot better shape than this one. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was interesting. I find this kind of stuff fascinating. You can see we have a sea of firewood out here, all the way over. We have the mothers of all branch piles, a Moab. I know it's not a bomb, but it's a mother of all branch piles, not just in front of my house, but in front of my neighbor's house as well. So there's a lot of brush that we got, a lot of trees with leaves on it that we got out, and there's still piles more. You can see here, there's just piles of it to go on forever and ever here that we're gonna be cleaning up and cutting up for the next several days. And then we'll get this fence put back up so Mr. Henderson, the puppy over here, can have a safe place to wander around during the day. I've gotta replace a couple of fence posts. One, you can see that orange cone there and the orange cone here. Well, the post that was in the middle here, it was rusted at the ground. In fact, it just kind of came off. So I'm going to replace that post. And there's one more post down there that is kind of about the same state, maybe a little better condition, but since I've got the fence up, I might as well replace it. They're not in cement, so it's not going to be very hard to take care of. I don't think they're in cement. But so that's the plan. The tree is down. Very exciting. Been waiting for that for a long time. So I know my neighbor here has been waiting for it for even longer. So he actually was talking to the previous owner about removing that tree. And it's just a lot of excitement around here. So if you're just stumbling along and just finding this channel, be sure and subscribe. It's Bowtie Life, and we talk mostly about gardening and sometimes about life, and we appreciate you watching. This is really just my personal log of things that are going on in the garden, and I enjoy logging stuff this way. You'll notice there's a big index on in the description on everything that's in here, and so I can go back and look at things when I want to. And this is no exception. So there's a lot of stuff that happened in here. Did you see the little section in there on the leaves growing out of the hot peppers? Oh, I'm so excited. I am so thrilled. We'll have another update on those here pretty soon. But yeah, that was very exciting. Be sure and click the thumbs up if you thought it was informational, educational, or just interesting, or if it was stupid, give me a thumbs down. It's all good. You have a right to your opinion. But anyway, all of it helps. Share on social media, let friends know about it. We're trying to grow the channel here, and appreciate having you along. Oh, there's a squirrel just jumped out of a tree. I think they're looking for their tree. I don't know if you can see him or not. Can you see him climbing? Yeah, there he is. Right there. I think he's a bit confused. Is he gonna climb the tree? Do squirrels have good eyesight? I don't know. Oh, there he goes. He's going up the tree. What's he gonna do? Is he gonna stand on the top and chatter? Look, he's at the top. That would be the first squirrel to climb up there. Anyway, hope you're having a happy new year. And as always, have a blessed day.